Hello friends, welcome to Textadiesel. In this video, we'll make a smart plant watering system using ESP32. Here ESP32 will create its own access point, so you just have to enter an IP to open the dashboard on your smartphone. You don't need any external IoT application, you don't need any internet connection. Now before going to the details, let me give you a quick demo how this project works. Here I have given the 12 volt DC supply, and instead of the pump I have connected this DC motor. Place the sensor inside the water. Now the moisture percentage is 92%, temperature reading is 31 degrees Celsius, humidity 56%, A indicates the circuit is in auto mode, also the yellow LED is glowing, and 0 indicates the motor is not running. Now let me quickly connect with the ESP32 access point. So let me turn on the Wi-Fi. Then I will search for ESP32 plant system. So this is our access point. Now after that, I will open the Google Chrome, enter the IP. So this is our IP. So in the dashboard, we can also monitor all the reading. Here you can see soil moisture 89%, temperature, humidity. Now as the circuit is in auto mode, if I remove the sensor from the water, the pump will automatically start. Here you can see. Now if I place the sensor inside the water, the pump will automatically stop. Now to go to manual mode, either I can tap this toggle mode button. So let me tap on the toggle mode button. Here you can see it is in manual mode. To see the updated reading, I have to press the refresh button. And in the dashboard, we can also see it is in manual mode. So in manual mode, I can control the pump either from this red button or with this push button. So let me turn on the pump from the dashboard. So here you can see the pump started. The buzzer is ringing as the moisture level is above 80%. Still the pump is on, so buzzer started. So let me turn it off from this red button. The pump off. Now to change the mode, either I can tap on this toggle mode button or I can press the push button. So let me press this push button to change the mode. So here you can see it is in auto mode and the pump is off. And if I tap on the refresh button, I can also see the updated reading on the dashboard. So this is a very useful project. After watching the complete video, you can easily make it. So without any further delay, let's get started. For this project, I have used the Altium PCB Designer software to draw the circuit, then design the PCB. Now Altium came up with an amazing product called Altium 365. Altium 365 is an electronic product design platform that unites PCB design, MCAD, data management, and teamwork. With Altium 365, you can not only design PCBs, but you can also share your projects to your teammates for review. It also provides automatic backup, centralized cloud storage, and a lot more. And if you are a student, you can also enroll Altium Student Lab for free to get access to Altium 365, online PCB design courses, and after completing the course, you will also get certificate of completion from Altium. And there are other key benefits, so I will highly recommend you to visit the Altium Student Lab. You can find the link in the description, then enroll with your university email ID. It's a great opportunity for the student, and it's also a great initiative from Altium to accelerate your skill in electronics design. These are the required components for this project. To control the water, you can either use a 12 volt solenoid valve or 12 volt DC pump. Now we have to connect all these components as per the circuit diagram. In the circuit, you have to give the 12 volt DC supply. Then for the ESP32, we are giving the 5 volt from the 7805 voltage regulator. And I have used 3.3 volt for the capacitive moisture sensor and the OLED. And as I said, you can either use 12 volt DC pump or 12 volt solenoid valve as per your requirement. To make the circuit compact, I have designed this PCB for this project. You can download the Gerber file from the video description. But in this video, I will make the complete circuit on a Zero PCB with the help of this PCB layout, which you can easily download from our website iotcircuithub.com. After downloading, print it on a A4 page. Then stick the layout on a Zero PCB and place all the components according to the layout. Then connect the components as per the circuit, and here you can see I can easily connect and solder all the components with the help of this bottom PCB layout. After soldering, our PCB is ready. Now let me connect the ESP32, then I will connect the OLED, then DHT11 sensor, then I will connect the capacitive moisture sensor. You can refer the circuit. Now I will quickly connect the ESP32 with my laptop to upload the code. These are the sketch for this project. Now this is the main sketch, and with the help of this sketch we will get the maximum and minimum reading from the moisture sensor, which will help us to calculate the moisture percentage. So let me open this get moisture sensor code in the Arduino IDE. Now in the sketch, here you can see the sensor is connected with the GPIO 34. Then in the void loop we are just printing the value from the moisture sensor. So now let me upload this code to ESP32. Here you can see I have selected the ESP32 board and COM port. Now let me upload it. After uploading, I will open the serial monitor. So this is the serial monitor, and here you can see the maximum value when the sensor is dry. Now let me dip it inside the water, and we will get the value if the sensor is wet, which is the minimum value from the sensor. Now using these two values, we can calculate the moisture percentage in the soil. Now let me open the main sketch with Arduino IDE. You can download the sketch from our website iotcircuithub.com. Just visit the related article, link is in description, then download the code from that article, and I have also explained this code line by line in that article. So if you have any query, you can always refer to the related article. Now for this project, I have used this version of the ESP32. Then you need these libraries. I have also mentioned the version. Then here you can see, first I am defining the OLED display height and width, and these are the GPIO pins I have used for this project. Then as I said, the ESP32 will create its own access point. So this is the name for that access point, and this is the password. If you want, you can change the name or password for the access point. Then this is the minimum value we got from previous code if the sensor is wet, and this is the maximum value. We have already got this value from the previous code. Then these two are the threshold value in percentage. Whenever the moisture content below 20%, the pump will start, and if the moisture content above 80%, then the pump will stop in auto mode. Then here I have set the interval 2 seconds. So after every 2 seconds, the value will be fetched from the sensors and displayed on the OLED. Now here you can see the HTML content. Then let me go to the void setup. So first we are defining the baud rate. Then we are configuring the GPIO pin, sensor, OLED display. Then in the void loop, here you can see after every 2 second interval, we are calling this three function to get the moisture reading, DHT11 sensor reading, then update the value in the OLED. We are using this function to control the buzzer in manual mode. Then if it is in the auto mode, then we are controlling the pump with this control pump function. So the code is very simple. I have explained the complete code line by line in the article. So if you have any query, please do visit the article. You can find the link in the description. Now let me go to the tool, select the board DUI ESP32 dev kit, then select the COM port, then hit the upload button. Now please refer to the circuit to connect the 12 volt DC supply, pump or solenoid valve, and DC buzzer with the PCB. After programming, I have connected the 12 volt supply. Instead of the pump, I have connected this DC motor and placed the sensor inside the pot. Now we are getting the moisture percentage 92%. Now let me connect with the ESP32 access point. So first I will turn on the Wi-Fi. Then I will search for the ESP32 plant system. Then enter the password 12345678. Now I will open the Google Chrome and enter the fixed IP. So this is the IP. So we can also monitor the dashboard on our mobile phone, and we can see the moisture percentage is 92%. Now let me remove the sensor from the pot. So now you can see the motor automatically started, and if I tap on the refresh button, we can get the moisture reading 18%. Now let me place the sensor inside the pot and again tap the refresh button, and now the soil moisture is 88%. Now let me change the mode. I will just tap on the toggle mode button and tap on the refresh button. Now it is in manual mode, so I can control the motor manually with this button. Let me turn on the motor. Here you can see motor started. Let me tap on it. The motor stops, and we can also control it from this manual push button. Let me try to turn on the motor. Again, you can see motor started. Let me tap on it. Motor stops. So this is a very useful project. You can easily make it without any Wi-Fi and PCB. So if you find this project helpful, then please hit the like button and share it with your friends. Don't forget to subscribe for more such videos. Thank you for watching. Have a great day.